All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Jazz Record Art Collective. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. We are coming to you live from the Fulton Street Collective in beautiful Chicago, Illinois. Tonight we are celebrating Dave Brubeck's 100th birthday. In doing that, we have the Richard Johnson Quartet performing his 1958 classic, Time Out. So we got two sets for you tonight, as we do with all of our performances here, accompanied by a live visual artist. Tonight's live visual artist, bringing him back, we dropped his jersey from the rafters to come out of retirement, Lewis Achenbach. Give it up for Lewis Achenbach. So he is in the lower right-hand side of your screen. He'll be painting the band as they perform. And what's really cool is you can buy his artwork. How do you do that? Well, in the lower left-hand side of your screen, that is how we're doing things. That's how we're taking care of the band. That is how we're taking care of the artists. And if you like what you see and like what you hear, you can also donate to Fulton Street Collective so we can keep doing this. We're making everything accessible and free, and we rely on your generosity and your kindness to keep this going. So please be joining us. It's always a good thing to support the arts. So we're going to start the show now. On drums, Charles Heath. On bass, Jeremy Boettcher. Saxophone, Sharel Cassity. And on piano, Richard Johnson. Thank you.
tuning in and checking us out on this wonderful day of Brubeck. If you don't know who he is, you probably know by now, because most jazz radio stations have been playing his music continuously for the past week. So hopefully you know who he is by now. We've had the pleasure of playing his music for about 2.5 years now, and that was intentional. I figured a couple years ago I should probably check this music out. It's great music. I hadn't spent the time doing it. And he's going to be 100, and I should know it. So as a piano player, I said, guys, let's get together and start working on it. So we did. So on bass, give it up, Mr. Jeremy Boettcher on the acoustic bass. That's right, this gentleman over here next to him is a good friend of mine. We play all the time at Andy's Jazz Club and all around the city. He's known as Charles Rick Heath. And the lady holding down the alto spot, if you don't know who she is, she's been mentored by James Moody, Jimmy Heath, you name it. The list goes on and on. She's toured all around the world, plays alto, tenor, soprano, some flute, and if you pay her enough, clarinet. Give it up, Sharel Cassity. Yeah. All right, so today we're going to be doing Brubeck's timeout recording and maybe a couple other standards depending on time. So once again, thanks for tuning in. I'm not going to talk all day, but I will say stick around, check it out, make some comments, hopefully positive comments, and donate if you can. Donate to the foundation here, give to Fulton Street, give to the artists. You know, make sure that they understand that they're loved. Spread the love. We all need love. Even if you're at home in your pajamas or working on the job, spread love. We need it, all right? So this next song is entitled Strange Metal Arc. If you've never heard it before, I hope you enjoy it after this. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That was entitled Take Five. And if you don't know that song, you probably don't live on planet Earth. That's one of the most popular songs, period. Not even in jazz. You hear it in the mall. You hear it in elevators. You hear it if you go to a car salesman shop playing above you. It's everywhere. It's very difficult to get away. And trust me, I've talked to little kids in the, you know, limited knowledge that they have. And they'll be like, oh, jazz, yeah. And you start playing that rhythm, and they know it. They may not know the title, but they know that song. So that song is the highest selling single for jazz. If you don't believe me, Google it. Everything's on Google. So today we're having some fun with some Brubeck music. We've been playing this literally all day. I'm not joking. If you don't believe me, go on the internet and check it out. Sound checks, rehearsals, we've played these tunes just today, probably 4 or 5 times. And it's challenging. It's very challenging music. Like I said earlier, I didn't check it out for a long time and I started studying it. It's very easy listening music, but when you really dig into it, Dave was into something. I don't know what he was eating, what kind of horses he was riding when he was a child, I don't know. But he was hearing different kind of time signatures at the same time, hence this record being called Time Out. I always thought it was called, you know, Time Out because of sports. Silly me, when I started checking it out, I was like, oh, it's Time Out because every song has a different time signature. Duh. And then on top of that, there's multiple time signatures in several tunes. Like this song we're about to play, Three to Get Ready. It's 3-4 or 4-4. You can count either one, and it works in both meters at the same time. It's very easy listening, but when you got to play this stuff, it's like jumping landmines. Seriously, it's like you're just trying, hoping not to hit something. So we're going to attempt this song today once again, and hopefully you enjoy it. Like I said, I've got a great team of musicians playing with me today. We've been playing this in several different formats and configurations over the years, and it's been great. You guys are getting the low down dirty version, just like you were in a jazz club at like 1 in the morning. And the guys have played it 5-6 times, and they're like, here's what you're going to get. And that's what we're giving to you. This isn't the pretty set. This is the we going to play set. And if you don't believe Dave could play, check out his live concerts. The record was one thing, but the live concerts, he was hitting hard. So that's what we're going for. If you don't like it, send us a small donation. If you do like it, send us a big donation, because we'll take it all.
Thank you.
All right, everybody clap, especially people from New York. Charles Heath on drums. Jeremy Boettcher on bass. Sharel Cassity on saxophone. Richard Johnson on piano. That is the end of set number one, or side one, if you will. We're going to take a short break. We're going to take a look at Lewis's work in the lower right-hand side of your screen, watch it develop, and hang out and be cool. Again, this is the time where you take out your phones and use those banking apps. Please tip the band. Please tip the artist. If you want to buy the artwork, it's available for you. If you like what you see in here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective so we can keep doing this. And that's about it. We're going to take about a 10 to 15 minute break, depending on how much we drink. And that's about it. We'll see you in just a few minutes. Stick around. Thank you. All right, we're back. Welcome to set number two, side number two. Give it up on drums, Charles Heath. On bass, Jeremy Boettcher. Saxophone, Sharel Cassity. And on piano, Richard Johnson. Thank you.
Thank you. That started off as Kathy's waltz. If you don't know who Kathy is, she's still alive. It was Dave Brubeck's. She was Dave Brubeck's daughter. Wonderful woman. And it's Kathy spelled with a K. A lot of people think C, but it's with a K. All right, and we ended with something that just came to my mind. I came out of the Baptist church, and I just started to hear that rhythm and decided I'm going to play that since it's Sunday. So if you have a problem with it, I'm sorry, but, you know, let us know via your comments. Comments are good, even if they're not good. Let us know. Comment here. Lots of artists come here to play. Let them know how you feel about their music, whether it's good or bad. It may affect them. It may not affect them. But for us, we like to take comments and tips, virtual tips online. And if you don't know where you can find it, look on your screen. It's right there. You can tip us. You can tip the location here. Be happy. You know, it's almost Christmas. Por favor, dame su dinero. Okay, la próxima vez, la próxima canción. Oh, there's mi mascarilla. The next song we're going to do is entitled Everybody's Jumping. If this doesn't get you jumping, try jumping. You never know. Mike, it gets us jumping. It's a hip tune. Okay, enough of that. Thank you. Thank you. That was Everybody's Jumping. So there's one more song on the famous recording, Time Out. We're about to do that. It's entitled Pick Up Sticks. What a lot of people don't realize, this is based upon an earlier rendition of a song that Dave wrote many years before called Watusi. And it's very interesting to hear the similarities between the two. So if you get a chance, you know, go to iTunes or Spotify, whatever musical stream you use, and check it out. It's definitely taken from that, one of his earlier tunes. And it's a fun tune for us. The basic melody line is in the bass. The bass, can you play the part the bass is going to play? So you're going to hear this line repeated over and over by Jeremy, and he's going to add his own thing to it, and hopefully you enjoy it. And then after that, we're going to play some standards that Dave enjoyed to play. He often played on several different festivals. All right, so stick around. Hopefully you're making those virtual tips out there to the location here, Fulton Street, and to us. And if not, hopefully you're listening and buying up some jazz. Since you're in the comfort of your own home, you know, it's a beautiful thing to be able to stream and check this out. Of course, we all want to be in person, but if you can't be there and you do really care, just dream that you're here and you can watch us. So sit back, relax, enjoy your tea, your water, your coffee, or whatever beverage of choice you're having, and check out this jazz. Give it up, Jeremy Boettcher on the acoustic bass. That's right. If you don't know his name, it's Jeremy. On the drums, we have Charles Rick Heath. That's right. And Sharel Cassity on the alto saxophone. So that gets us through the Time Out recording. If you don't know what it is, please listen to it. It's great recording, great music. They spent lots of time recording that. There's two great books that came out in the past year that I've read. I had the opportunity to speak to Dave's lawyer. I called him up because I wanted to know more information. And we ended up talking for an hour. I didn't know this guy. He looked at my website. He was full of information. Dave had two lawyers in his life, he told me. A person before him, and then he joined the team in 1971. So he had lots of information about the songs, about tours, his personality. So I learned a lot from him, and we stay in contact. There's another gentleman, the only guy of the famous quartet that's still alive is the bass player. A lot of people don't know that. His name's Eugene Wright. He currently resides in California, and he is still alive. He's out there full of music. And it's just surprising to me how much his name does not come up. And he was the only African-American in the group. And he has lots of stories about all kinds of things, about everything. So if you get a chance, send him an email. He's definitely reachable. He's not leaving his house at his age, and most of us aren't during these days. But it's good to know somebody out there still has a lot of good information. His name's Eugene Wright. So what we're going to do now is a couple songs that Dave made popular. One is entitled In Your Own Sweet Way. This was a song that's a great jazz standard. He used to love to play it. Miles recorded it. A lot of jazz musicians have recorded it. You know, Dave was friends with all the cats. All the cats. They were friends on tour. So don't get it twisted. They were good friends, and they respected each other. So we're going to do In Your Own Sweet Way. Thank you. Thank you. That was our rendition of In Your Own Sweet Way. So we have time for one more. Hopefully you guys have been enjoying yourself out there. We've been enjoying ourselves. If you can't tell, it's only because we've had on masks. We've been smiling and cracking jokes, and you're just going to have to believe us. And if you don't, email me, and I'll let you in on the jokes. So it's been a pleasure being here, as always. This next song we're going to do is a song, a standard. Most jazz musicians have played. Dave used to play this a lot. He really enjoyed it. It's How High the Moon. And we're going to do some trading between Sharel and I. And trading, all that means is I'm going to play a little. She's going to play a lot. She's going to play a lot. I'm going to play a little. And this goes back and forth until they get tired of playing. And the drummer usually gives us a big pow. And that means time to end the song. So please give to this wonderful establishment. They've been working hard, not just with us, but with hundreds and hundreds of other musicians in and out of town. We have to keep these venues going, and this is the way to do it. If you don't believe me, if you don't remember anything I say, tune back in, listen, watch. Even if you can't tune in, give. Those of you who can, give and support the music. And if you can't, listen to the music. Tell somebody about it, even if it's your enemy. Say, you know what, I don't like you, but here's some jazz. They may be become your friend. You'll be surprised. You will definitely be surprised. They may say, you know what, I actually like my neighbor now. You never know. So, I'm Richard Johnson, rjjazz.com. That's Sharel Cassity. Jeremy Boettcher on the bass. Charles Rick Heath on the drums. That's right. Give it up to our artist. He's been over here working hard. If you can't see him on the screen, oh, he's got his own little drums over there. See, he want to join the band. All right. Okay, if you want to do that, you got to come to the crib, first of all, which nobody's going to anybody's house right now. But you can come. And you got to rehearse with us. So, but I have my mom cook you some food. She's from down south. All right. Yeah, so. All right. So sit back, relax. Give. If you want to see more of this program, this type of programming, send an email in. Make a comment. Send a comment. Comment. If you don't understand what I'm saying, I'm speaking English. Okay. Deje tu comentarios aquí ahora. Es más importante. Okay. In Spanish, if you don't get that, I'm sorry, I can't help you. Thank you.
All right, that is Richard Johnson Quartet. Charles Rick Heath on drums. Jeremy Boettcher on bass. Sharel Cassity on saxophone. Lewis Achenbach, paints, brushes, canvas. Lower right hand side of your screen. And on piano, Richard Johnson. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're back here tomorrow night, same station, same channel, same time, with the Marcus Rutz Quintet with their album release, Blueprints Volume 2. Please come back for that. This is very much a collaborative effort. It is a collaborative effort. Give it up on sound tonight, Kenny Kellmeyer. Claymeyer. Thank you. I got it right. Only after 9 months. The gentleman who is on camera and lens, who takes photographs of all of our performances, puts them online, Harvey Tillis. And the man behind the scenes who makes the band look good, he's working hard while the band is playing, Jose Valle. All right, so that's it for tonight. Like I said, we're back here tomorrow night. This is the time of the night. Again, reaching those cell phones, the fancy cell phones. Please be generous. Please be kind. You see bar after bar, venue after venue, restaurant after restaurant, slowly withering away, and we don't want that to happen. So please be generous, thoughtful, and kind, because we want to keep doing this, and just we thank you for your support. We're going to zoom in on Lewis's work, and until then, keep your masks on. Stay safe.
The